So, what can I do for you, Mynir?
Thank you. I am here on behalf of Dr. White. It is time the campaign against him came to an end. Who is selling the papers that slander him?
Well, you won't find argument from me. Doc Lyle healed my leg good as new. The pamphlets are being distributed by a few paper boys around Boston.
I get for this, though.
Where's the man printing these pamphlets?
Look, mister, there's a man who pays me to hand these papers out. So long as he's doling the coin, I'll be doing what he asks.
Come see the new summer designs at Miss Br-
Expressing sincere condolences to the Brown family, Mr. Roberts would like to remind the city
I'll enjoy
youth
this
not to pray near the manufacturing building.
You will not distribute.
Gentlemen dilettantes, amateurs, and the curious public. Will demonstrate tomorrow by the belfry his latest giant net for the entrapment of plummeting objects.
Looks worse than it is. Just keep it clean and you should be fine. Honor, I simply can't get to all these men in reasonable time. I need help. From you, from anyone! I think I have someone for you. Diana, come with me. I need your help.
Of course. What's the matter?
Dr. White is overwhelmed and needs some extra hands.
I'm no doctor, Connor.
Maybe not. But I have seen you care for people before. You have the way of it. Diana, perfect. I'm told you have a healer's hand. Please see to this young man. Connor, if you could help the two gentlemen out front.
Thanks, Skip. Good of you to help. And I should be all right.
Many thanks, Captain.
That's a spot better, sir. Thanks.
Caught a piece of shrapnel in the shoulder. Bad luck. Thank you, Captain.
Caught some burn off a rope. It happens. Thanks, Skipper.
You did well, Connor. But Diana, you impressed me greatly.
Well, thank you, Doctor. I haven't studied the practice or anything.
Maybe not, but your instincts are superb, and you have a healer's touch. If you had the time, I would be grateful for your help on a more regular basis.
Maybe Catherine could watch the young ones a few days a week.
And if she can't, we'll find someone who will.
Good day, Connor.
Hello, Dr. White. Diana?
Hello there, Connor.
Diana and I were just having a look over our equipment and facilities. They've seen a great deal of use in the last few days.
So things have turned for the better?
Better than it ever was in Boston. I was missing my apprentice when things first exploded, but now I have Diana. She's better than he was in every respect.
And are you happy, Diana?
I never thought this would be my path, but now that I'm here, I admit it feels right.
One day, Doc, one day, you'll find one too. She'll come wandering into the village and light up your life. Mark my words, I'm telling you. I have a sense for these things.
Might be, might be. Ahoy, Connor! Look at us! Three bachelors waiting for love, waiting for a drink, whatever comes first. Drink wins!
Women will be lining up for you, Doc, I'm telling you. Ladies love a healer. It's me that's doomed. Who wants to marry a woodworker, eh? Who? Nobody is who.
Hogwash! You brought the folding chair to the Americas. You're a pioneer, an entrepreneur. Women appreciate a man with vision.
What about you, Connor? How is it a man like you has no wife?
I would not be a good husband. I have not the time to give. One day, perhaps. Old man. Achilles.
What is it?
Achilles has passed.
I'm so sorry.
He passed peacefully and with dignity.
A service, then?
Yes. Please prepare something appropriate. I will see the grave is dug. Can you gather everyone?
Anna, if you are reading this, I have failed to say goodbye as I wanted, but the time never seemed appropriate. I leave this land and all its resources to you. I trust you now know this place has become something of great significance. A community to serve as an example of what this would-be nation could become. But the larger and stronger it grows, the more fragile and difficult to defend it becomes. I hope your friends who are birthing this infant country understand this truth. Your unwavering tenacity and honesty have burdened you with responsibility far greater than any one man should bear. But you, if anyone, are capable. You have given an old man hope that all is not lost. And for that, I thank you. I ask that you lay my bones to rest on the hill overlooking the water. There is no other place on this earth I'd rather be. I am grateful to have met you, knowing you will guide this land and these people to a better future. Yours in brotherhood, Achilles.
Prayer and sermon do not suit this occasion. Achilles was not a man of God. Not my God, at any rate. But he certainly believed in a guiding force. And he is at peace now, and for that we can be grateful. We lay him to rest here, atop the bluff where he made his honorable and dignified life, so he can remain that comforting presence, the old man on the hill, that we have all grown to depend on. You all had your own relationships with him, your own moments. And I implore you to return here when the time is right for you and share those stories with the waves and the trees. Achilles, you will be missed, but never forgotten. Go safely, old man. Safely to where your soul need rest.
I will make you proud, old man. Thank you.